Hey everyone, we're back with another screencast. This time providing an update to our top viewed video, How to Get the Most Out of Apple's Reminders. If you haven't seen it, that video covered reminders in iOS 12. Last September, Apple made some significant changes to reminders in iOS 13 that we think you're really going to love. Here's hoping our sequel is as big a hit as the original. I'm Jonathan Moore, and this is Interlinked Training. Before we get started, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so YouTube will let you know the moment we publish new videos. It's important to note that this lesson can be applied directly to reminders on the iPad, as it's exactly the same interaction model, just with a larger canvas. It can also be applied to reminders on the Mac in macOS Catalina, though it's slightly different due to the mouse-driven interface. If you'd like us to cover reminders for Mac in a future video, let us know in the comments. We'll be covering three main topics today, with lots of helpful tips and tricks along the way. Those topics will be timestamped down below in the description if you'd like to skip right to those sections. They are creating reminders, organizing, sharing, and smart lists, and creating reminders with Siri. Okay, let's get into it. By default, Apple includes your first reminders list, simply called Reminders. We'll be going over lists and organization in a bit, but let's hop into this list to get started. To create a reminder, hit the plus button on the bottom left. I'll type, do the laundry. Of course, you can tap inside any reminder you've created, and off to the right will be an information icon. When you tap on that, you're presented with options to add notes or a URL to your reminder, date and time, which are now two separate options. This can be helpful if you just want to be reminded on a day with no particular time in mind. Other options include repeat, now with lots more choices for custom repeats. This was a concern for a few viewers of our previous reminder video, so we wanted to call this out. In the iOS 12 version of reminders, the options for repeats were fairly limited. For example, you couldn't create a reminder that would repeat every 2 or 3 hours. Now you can, by tapping on Custom at the bottom, choosing your reminder frequency, and then setting the intervals. Okay, hopping back out to the main window, repeats are followed by location, which functions exactly as it did in iOS 12, and next up, which is new in iOS 13, the ability to be reminded when messaging with someone. When you toggle that on, you choose a person from your address book, and the next time you're messaging with them, you'll be reminded. I can't tell you how many times we've wished for a feature like this, and now it's here. Rounding out the bottom, we have the ability to flag the reminder, set its priority, move it to a different list, create subtasks of that reminder, and lastly, add an image. Let's hop back out to our reminder. You may have noticed a row of icons above the keyboard. This is a new feature in iOS 13 that allows you to quickly add date and time or locations to reminders, as well as flag your reminder and attach an image. It works just like the info window, but quicker. Let's demo that. When I tap a date, it gives me quick options for today, tomorrow, next weekend, or a custom date. All I have to do is tap one of those to apply it to the reminder. Same goes for location. When I tap that, it offers home, work, getting in the car, or a custom location. When I tap flag, the reminder is flagged and will show up under the flag section of the smart filters. More on that later. Lastly, when I tap the camera icon, I can take a new picture, choose an existing one from my photos library, or scan a document. It's very cool that Apple has put these features right in the reminders creation process. But wait, it gets better. You can now use natural language input to assign dates or locations as you type the reminder. Check this out. So if I type, walk the dog tonight at 7 p.m., the text turns blue, and right above the keyboard, I can tap on the suggested time to set it into my reminder. This works with locations too. When I type walk the dog when I arrive at home, the same suggestion pops up and I can add it immediately. So neat. Now let's go over the new subtasks feature. Sometimes you have a task that has other tasks associated with it. Before iOS 13, there was no way to associate subtasks with a main task. Now it's possible, and Apple has provided three different ways to do it. First, if you are in list view, you can simply drag one reminder on top of another to make it a subtask. Second, if the two reminders are right next to each other, you can swipe right on the one below to indent it to the one above. Lastly, if we go back to the info panel, we can create subtasks directly from there. Before we head to the next part of our tutorial, I want to share another neat way to make a reminder, and that's directly from within the Mail app. If you've been tasked with something in an email, you can select the text of that task. Tap Share, tap Reminders, and you'll be able to create a reminder based off the text from the email. What's more, there is a deep link to the email embedded in the reminder. So even if that email gets moved to a different folder, the reminder can still find it, which is just so useful. Once you're happy with it, just choose Add at the top. Okay, time for some organizing. With iOS 12 reminders, organizing was basically non-existent. The only way to differentiate between your lists was with its title and color. In addition, foldering your lists was also not possible. Thankfully, Apple has added some pretty robust options for list organization. Let's take a look. From the main reminder screen, you'll see the default reminders list, with a blue list icon to its left. That works just fine for a generic reminders list. But what about one for groceries, home improvement, or your pets? Let's create a list for each of those and take a look at our options. To create a new list, tap on Add List on the bottom right. When you do, you're presented with a brand new interface for adding colors and icons. I'm going to create a groceries list. Make it green and add the carrot icon. Next, let's make one for home improvement and label it gray with the house icon. And lastly, one for pets, labeling it orange with the paw icon. So, in looking at these, what might they all have in common? To us, they seem to all be home-related tasks. It would be great if we could group them together, right? Well, now we can. There are two ways to do it. First, we can tap the Edit button, then tap Add Group on the bottom left, name the group, and if we want, add the reminder lists we want included right from there. Additionally, from List View, we can drag lists on top of each other to create groups. It's super easy and kind of fun. Once we've got everything in the group, we can tap the disclosure triangle to open and close the group when we want to view its contents. So now we've got our list created and organized. What about sharing them with other people? Reminders has it covered. Simply tap on a list, then tap the ellipses on the top right, and the option to add people to the list is right there, along with other options to edit the list's name and appearance, delete the whole list, select multiple reminders for moving or deleting, and to show completed reminders. Being able to find and act on certain reminders quickly is incredibly useful, and Apple has added some useful smart lists to do that. You'll find them right above the My Lists section. There are four smart lists, one for reminders due today, another for reminders that have been scheduled, which won't include location or messaging-based reminders, one for all reminders, and lastly, reminders that have been flagged. And right above the smart filters will be the search function, which Apple claims is far more accurate in iOS 13 than it was before, and we would agree with that. Okay, we've got them all organized. Let's put Siri to work. We went over creating reminders with Siri extensively in our previous video on reminders, and creating reminders with Siri in iOS 13 is largely unchanged. Check out that video for a more in-depth look. We've got it linked in the top right. That section of the video begins at 3 minutes and 56 seconds. We promise, you'll learn something you didn't know. So how do we create a date and time reminder with Siri? Simple. Activate Siri and say, "Remind me to walk the dog today at 12 p.m.
Done.
If we didn't have a specific time in mind, we could say remind me tomorrow morning to be reminded at 7 a.m., tomorrow to be reminded at 9 a.m., tomorrow afternoon to be reminded at noon, and tomorrow evening to be reminded at 6 p.m. To be reminded based on location, just say, "Remind me to walk the dog when I get home."
Done.
Or, "Remind me to talk to my boss about the meeting when I get to work."
Done.
And don't forget, you can be reminded based on your car's Bluetooth connection by saying something like, "Remind me to call work when I get in the car."
Okay.
The new "Remind me when messaging a person" feature is also available with Siri. And if you think you could ask something like, "Remind me to ask about the flight itinerary when messaging Ian Lambert,"
done.
You'd be right on the money. Of course, context-based reminders are still around. These are reminders that can only be created with Siri. If you're looking at one of Apple's default apps, like a web page in Safari, an email in Mail, or perhaps a note in the Notes app, and you want to be reminded of that specific item, make sure to have it up on screen and be looking at it. Activate Siri and say, "Remind me about this," and then add the day and time, location, or when messaging a person criteria at the end. One related question that comes up often is, can we add items to our reminder lists with Siri? Absolutely. Simply say something like, "Add bananas to my grocery list."
Done.
One caution on that. It's important to use the exact name of the list, or you may confuse Siri. As you can see, Apple has really put a lot of work into making reminders a real contender in the task management space. It was already one of our most used apps, and now it's just completely indispensable. That said, if you need a supercharged task manager, you might want to consider giving the Omni Group's OmniFocus a look. It's really incredible. We hope you got a lot out of this Interlinked training video. If you have any questions about what you learned or feedback for us, let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, consider giving it a like, and if new to the channel, subscribing. Also, we've got some topics in mind for future videos, but honestly, our opinion is less valuable than yours. Let us know some areas about which you'd like to learn more. We're eager to read your suggestions. You can leave them in the comments or send them to us via Twitter, Facebook, or email. Thanks for watching, and we hope you visit again soon. See you next time.